there was a lot of acres that didn't get planted, millions of acres that didn't get planted across the Midwest.
We can't solely blame the record-breaking cold for this.
It's kind of been a domino effect the whole year. Started out with the excessive moisture in the spring and kind of pushed us back, and now we're trying to harvest, you know, in mid-November in the snow. So it's just been a challenge all around.
The perfect storm for this, for the agriculture community, it's not just been the weather. We've been experiencing propane shortage right here in Iowa, and I know it's more than Iowa. It's like the whole state of Iowa and Minnesota and Wisconsin. And
Farmer Billy Danner in West Liberty, Iowa, and Krista Swanson in Oneida, Illinois, have seen it all this season.
It seems like this year just keeps throwing curveballs at us with the weather.
It has been the most challenging year, I would say, in my farming career of about 30 years.
Just to add insult to injury, there were several blasts of frigid air. This one packed the biggest punch because of the number of record-breaking cold temperatures. Here's why. There was already snow on the ground, especially across much of the upper Midwest. Additional snow lagged behind the actual frontal system itself as it drug far to the south. That helped to intensify that incoming CA air, or continental Arctic air mass. The core of the cold sunk its teeth into the middle of the country.
AccuWeather expert senior meteorologist Dave Dombeck says that the upcoming weather pattern looks far more promising.
There will be bouts where there will be some precipitation at times, but they're quick hitters. They're going to move through, do their thing.
Dave, keep that good news coming.
In between those precipitation events, there'll be long stretches of dry weather, which again is really good news for the farmers.
Excellent news, since a lot of ground still needs to be covered.
We're already running, a week later than when we've ever finished in the past, and still have 2/3 of our corn left to go.
But the finish line is in sight.
You can make up about 10% per week, like working pretty much full time in the harvest. So if you're 10% behind, you can make that up in a week.
The work to the end won't be pretty, but as long as Mother Nature doesn't throw any more curveballs, the Midwest farmers will be able to complete harvesting. Reporting for AccuWeather, I'm meteorologist Lauren Rainson.